So we were approached by a group associated with the Swiss Development Corporation. And this was a group of Mongolian researchers that were working for the Swiss Development Corporation that were interested in rangeland health. How do we monitor rangeland health? How do we characterize rangeland health? And then how do we use that to improve rangeland management? One of the things that we've managed to accomplish with our Swiss partners and with the Mongolian researchers is first to establish a nationwide monitoring program that uses consistent methodology and that is readily interpretable in terms of rangeland health. The second part of our engagement, so this goes back to about 2006, now that we have the monitoring data, how do we interpret the data? And what does it mean in terms of what a degraded site is, what a healthy site is, and what the management needs are? Basically, we have too many livestock, and they are grazing year-round in many of these places. And what we think needs to happen is a reduction in the livestock numbers and allowing certain parts of the range to rest. In interpreting the data across the country, one of the things that we found with our Mongolian partners is that most of the rangelands are recoverable. There are certainly cases where we have complete loss of the soil profile. Those places will never recover. There's not much we can do about that. But for most of the area, changes in grazing management will yield improvements. There are a couple of initiatives that people are talking about that we're going to work with our Mongolian partners to help test, and that's the effect of grazing fees, and then perhaps payment for ecosystem services that may be used to reduce the stocking rates that will allow us to begin to rest some of these areas. So yeah, the ideal situation would be for the Mongolian government to pass a land law, but that is pretty far off. And so one of the ideas that we've been talking about is actually work at the local level. What's interesting is the folks who really want things to change are the local government officials and the herders themselves. So we're going to be working with those communities to try to implement some of these ideas in some test areas with the idea that they may inspire similar sorts of changes nationwide if they're successful. One of the interesting elements of this work is the multinational collaboration that was involved in bringing this together. The funding has actually largely been provided by the Swiss government. Because of our expertise in rangeland management issues, we were brought in, and then of course we have the Mongolians who are very familiar with how their system works and the situation on the ground. So that combination of concepts and expertise and across a couple of different countries is what made it happen.